Okay, here we are, just getting ready to install the cockpit. I want to show you the reinforcement I did. What it is, took a balsa stripper, and you need to get a you need to get a good medium, hard to medium 16th inch balsa. You don't real soft. This is a good medium, and I cut it in strips of a quarter inch wide, and then I also made a piece that's a half inch wide. But how I did the reinforcement is I just cut a piece of quarter inch wide from to fit in between. Now there's a little fillet on the inside where they held this former in, and you can go ahead and either glue it in and sand it off later, or just kind of taper the end of the sheet or the stringer to where it'll fit flush. But anyway, all I did was I used a good 80 grit sandpaper, and I sand the inside of that whole area, because you want to give the epoxy something to bite to. Anyway, I take that and I just glued it in place along the just underneath the edge here, and then I just take little clamps all the way across there and hold it in place. Once I got the first one in, I went ahead and did the same thing right under it, another quarter inch piece. The reason you can't go a half inch all at one time is because there is a change in the contour, and you don't want to change your fuselage shape at all. So anyway, you put a quarter and then another quarter. Then I came back, I went and sanded that to where they contoured to each other. And then I went back and put a half inch piece, and you can CA it to the other two, and you don't have to use epoxy. And then I went back with another piece of quarter and filled in the space we had in here, and that was exactly a quarter inch. I've done the same thing to the front along here. I did a quarter inch piece all the way to the next former, another quarter inch piece all the way to the next former underneath that, and then went back with a half inch piece. Something you can also do, and I will include a big enough piece of ABS, is I ran 16th inch up the side here, and what I'll do is I'll end up gluing a piece of ABS. It fills in this area here, plus it'll, we can put a piece of 16th, glue a piece of 16th inch, excuse me, a piece of ABS to this and paint it the same color as our cockpit, and it'll look like our cockpit continues on up. So, but that's a quick show you how I did the reinforcement. Strengthens it up. It just gives you, just backs that fiberglass up, since we did remove some of the servo tray. Anyway, I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to get the other side done. I just finished this one, and then we'll move on to installing our cockpit. Okay, here we are back at the fuselage, finally getting ready to install the cockpit itself. I've already got all the doublers in, the 16th balsa all in place. One thing I do want to tell you, if you plan on putting a piece of 16th inch and then cover it with ABS in here, make sure that your dash is you've got it installed, not temporarily installed, and mark that location first, because you don't want to add to the thickness of this, because this part was made to contour with the fuselage itself and not any extra added thickness. So anyway, but to install the cockpit, come in here, it's a flat piece like always on mine, and come in here and take your crimp and crimp it all the way down. Now you need to clean all the edges off. It's from a taper from zero, just to the thickness of the where it starts to curve, where the flashing is, zero to that. Anyway, as far as the upper rail that comes out this way, you need to come off, start at 3/8 of an inch from the back corner end board, and then from this tip in 3 inches. So it's 3/8 on this side and in 3 inches. This is a little bit wider than 3/8, but you need to trial fit it first to see how it's going in. Now I haven't added any of the extras here. If you turn this, before you actually start working on it, if you turn it to the light, you'll see some real small divots in this area here. You drill those out with a 3/64 inch drill, and you can see where I can put a toothpick through, and we can make, well, I think on this that they actually look more like push buttons. So you would take and do your toothpick same way, but kind of get rid of the sharp edge and make it look a little bit more blunt. And these would be black in color, unlike the silver ones for the toggle switches on some of the other airplanes. Okay, so you have to get those there. I'll show you where the throttle controls and all that go here in a little bit. But I want to go ahead and show you how to install this. But this is easily installed. Hopefully it'll be easy. Anyway, just come in from the bottom. Bring it up and it just locks over the edges. I'm going to, so I don't push it in when I'm doing the instrument panel, I'm going to take these edges down real quick because I do have to put just a tad of pressure and it can push it out. But anyway, once that's installed, as far as putting the dash in, you need to go ahead and get it done. It has some holes on this also. There's a panel here. If you hold it to the like I said, to the light, you'll see the divots. Drill it out with a 3/64-inch drill, and the same thing with the toothpicks. You can make your toggle switches or your push buttons with that. There's also a lever here and a lever here. I have not installed those yet. But anyway, to install this, you just go back, drop the bottom down, and slide it up into place. There is some, you'll be able to see it where the stringers stop. You can pull this up close to in place on both of that. Just make sure they're both even. And then we would glue that in place. You could also, if you want, like I do in the past, is take a piece of 1/16-inch balsa and put it on the back of that instrument panel to kind of give a little bit of strength. Okay, once that's installed, I've got the armored plate, armored headrest. I'm gonna go get the parts for that, and I'll show you how I put that together really quick. Okay, here are the parts for the armored headrest. I made this where it's pretty easy to put together. What you need to do is you need to cut it out and make sure you cut it close enough that you get all, I still haven't cut this in quite close enough, to where you get all the flashing, the part that turns out, off. You need to do that all the way around. That's the main piece that has your angle on it. Also, you got a rear piece of the top and a rear piece for the bottom. What you do is once you cut these out, they should just slide or fit inside one of them. I've made them where they just small enough to fit right inside. This makes you a nice strong piece. Once you glue it, you should use the Model Masters or Testor's liquid cement. It's a good glue. It takes a little while to set up, but it'll make a good strong joint. Also, there is a seam all the way around. You can take that and fill that with whatever type filler you want to make it look better. But that makes a good strong part. Now, there's also radio boxes that were on the back of the armored headrest. What you need to do is go ahead and paint the whole thing. The one with the single dial goes on the bottom. The dual one goes the next one up, and then the two blank boxes go up on top. Anyway, get them all painted. Once you get them painted, go on the inside, and you need to cut the flat. You need to cut enough of this flashing off that it's square, that it doesn't have anything that rounds out. Anyway, you need to run a good bead of glue around it, and like I said, it's all painted, and then lay it down on there and let it sit. That glue will go ahead; it will go through the paint and hook to the ABS below. But the good thing about this headrest is that I've set it up where it locks in place. If this is all comes together correctly, you should be able to turn it at an angle, pull, and it should just pop into place. Now, you do have to set the angle according to the rear cannon.